After you've prepared a pricing scheme, the next step is to set up rate plans. First, create a rate plan template that references the pricing scheme. The rate plan template defines the charges for which the pricing scheme calculates the corresponding price elements. Second, use this template in the product to create its rate plans. The rate plan specifies the billing options per market, so you need a rate plan for each market where you sell the product. Let's see what these steps look like. You need two apps for the setup: Manage Rate Plan Templates and Manage Products. The first step is to create the rate plan template, and we choose the option to create a template based on a pricing scheme. Start by assigning the pricing scheme that you created in a previous step. Once it's assigned, you can take a look at the pricing scheme if needed. The next step is to define the billing settings for the template. The billing cycle, which determines the billing frequency and the start of the cycle, the billing profile, and the currency. You can configure these either as values, if you want to predefine a fixed value for all the rate plans that are based on this template, or you can configure them as parameters. We recommend that you define them as parameters because they are more flexible. Parameters allow you to customize the value for each rate plan or market. After that, the last step is to create the charges or credits. There are three types: one-time, recurring, and usage-based. Let's see an example. We create a recurring and a one-time charge. For each charge, we have to select a rate element. The rate element determines basic aspects of the charge, such as the unit or the data source. You choose the relevant rate element depending on how you're pricing the charge. For example, a recurring fee could have a fixed value, like the monthly fee for a streaming service, or could have a license-based value, like the number of software licenses that an IT company pays for their developers. You define the possible rate elements in business configuration. After selecting the rate elements for the charges, we're done with creating the rate plan template. Here, it's also important to remember that the pricing scheme is applied to each charge in the rate plan template. This means that the assigned pricing scheme must be defined in a way that only the relevant price elements are calculated for each charge. Let's see what this looks like for our charges. The pricing scheme that we assign contains steps that specify how the price for each charge is calculated. The steps that don't apply to the template are skipped. In our example, the calculation of the usage price is skipped, as the template has no usage-based charge. Once everything is complete, publish the template to start using it. Now continue with the setup in the product. We've already prepared the product, so let's focus on the creation of the rate plans. Here, it's important to know that if you use several rate plan templates to create rate plans for a product, the templates must all either be based on a pricing scheme or not. Start by choosing the template that we just created and the market for this rate plan. After giving a name to the rate plan, continue with the billing settings. The currency is predefined by the market. With this, the rate plan is finished. We repeat the same steps for the other markets where we sell the product. Don't worry about this warning. This message indicates that the prices are missing in the lookup table data. You define the applicable prices in a later step. That sums up how to use pricing schemes in SAP subscription billing. Thank you for watching.